Okay, I'm ready to do this. I've got a steaming mug of chamomile tea. Chamomile, how do you pronounce it? Hello friends, my name is Jackie. Welcome to Super Enthused. If you're new here, my channel's called Super Enthused because, well, I'm pretty enthused about stuff that I cover on my channel, so welcome. And for those of you who have been around with me for a while, welcome back, and this is my first time doing something like this. So, here we go. I'm doing a get to know you video. Well, get to know me. If you've been around my channel for a while, you've gotten to know me a little, and I've gotten to know many of you a little because our interactions in the comments, and some of you guys are my friends on Instagram, Twitter, some of you like the Super Enthused Facebook page, all of which I highly encourage you to do because I'm active on the Super Enthused Instagram, Super Enthused Twitter. I do have some notes here, so I'm not just going to ramble on and on, so let's get to it. I was inspired to do this by my friend Brian, Orlando Theme Park 360. You've seen him in some of my videos, and I've been in some of his videos. We went to Toy Story Land opening day together, and he's a really good friend. I would say he tagged me. If by tag, you mean texted me and was like, hey, you should do this. So technically, I was tagged by Brian, Orlando Theme Park 360, to do this. So thanks, Brian, for the inspiration. And by now, he's probably put his get to know me type video out. So you should definitely go check that out and get to know Brian because he is a great guy to get to know, very talented and cool person. But back to me. Here's the way we're gonna do this. This is going to be, and it's partly Christmas themed, a past, present, and future get to know me. Sort of like the ghost of Christmas past, the ghost of Christmas present, and the ghost of Christmas future. Even though this isn't a Christmas vlog, my Christmas tree is behind me, it is the holiday season right now, so I figured to give this some structure and a little bit of a holiday theme, we're gonna do past, present, and future, and we're gonna move through this quickly. So here we go. Let's start with the past, and I won't go too far back. I was born in the city of Miami, I was, but I won't go all the way back. What I'll do is talk about how I got to where I am today with Super Enthused, with this YouTube channel. It started out as a blog. I started the blog in like 2015-ish. I actually think I started it before then, but I think 2015 is when I started to write blog posts. And I started out writing like trip reports, basically. I would go to like a Renaissance festival and I would take photos and I would post a sort of write-up of the event with my reviews, tips, thoughts, and photos of the event. It was sort of like a blog post, trip report type of thing. I loved doing this. I still love doing it. It's really, really fun. It's a cool way to store your memories and share with people. And when people are maybe Googling like what an event is like, these types of blog posts can be very helpful. You have an idea of like what kind of food is there, what kind of event it is, what you can expect and what to prepare, and just, and maybe for people who will never be able to attend these events, it's a cool way to kind of know like what goes on and what they're like. I know for me, I love reading them as well. I read a lot of blogs like that and still do, so it's something I enjoy doing. So as I'm writing the blog posts, I really enjoy writing. I've always loved to write. We'll go a little bit further back. Some of you know that I used to play in indie rock bands. I used to sing, write lyrics, and play bass and keyboard. And the reason I played bass, I don't know if I've told this story, maybe some of you know, was sort of out of necessity. One of the bands that I was in, we were touring, we were playing a lot of shows, we were very active, and we just couldn't hold on to a reliable bass player. It was me, a guitarist and a singer and a drummer, and we were all very dedicated and we were ready to just play shows every night and tour the country and we wanted to go for it. And it was just one night like, well, why don't you learn to play the bass, Jackie? And I was like, okay. Sure, like I've taken piano lessons in my life, I've taken singing lessons, like I used to sort of know how to read music, I can figure this out. Not that there was any music reading involved in this, but like I can keep a really good rhythm and, you know, I can stay on point of a song, you know? So I learned to play bass specifically for the indie band that I was in so that we could be very active, play lots of shows, and tour the USA. I've toured the USA a few times over. Eventually, I took over most of our tour booking duties, and I really loved it. I love planning and organizing. I love planning trips and travel, and I loved booking tours. I just loved it. Back then, I used MySpace a lot. Like, I used email and I made phone calls, but a lot of the tours were booked through MySpace because a lot of venues had a MySpace page. So it was a really, really fun community, and there's a lot of parallels between that and the YouTube community of nowadays that I see. A lot of the DIY spirit and the spirit of collaboration, working together for creative projects to put, you know, whether it's music or videos or something creative and positive out into the community. So anyway, I loved being the band, I loved touring the country. One of the most surprising things about touring was meeting people all over America who were just so kind. It had a big impact on me. I have always loved road trips. I loved road trips before then, but it just instilled this never-ending love of road trips in me. I love to travel, but I specifically, particularly love road trips. I love getting in the car, getting behind the wheel of the car, and just let's go. I've been all the way up to Bellingham, Washington, Vashon Island, saw the bioluminescence in the waters, just amazing things all over the country, and met amazing people. So, playing in bands, touring the country, and then I went to graduate school. I have a master's degree in religious studies. It's not theology, it's religious studies, and my focus was sociology. So I kind of stopped touring to get that master's degree and focus on my education, and that was awesome. Another amazing experience meeting people from all over the world. So I'm gonna skip over a lot because a lot has happened, but basically starting a career and education, doing all the things I've done, I kind of got to a point where I was like, I need a creative outlet again. You know, I don't really play music anymore. I still love music and I still love to sing, and anyone who knows me knows I'll sing any chance I get, but I just didn't want to live the band life anymore. So it came to a point again where I was like, I need a new creative hobby. I need something new to do. Like, I was writing in journals and I was writing poetry and I was doing my thing here and there. And I tried to crochet for a little while and I had some fun with that. I made a scarf and some stuff. I started the blog and I loved, loved, loved it. The blog was really, really great for me, at least. I don't know how many other people were reading it. It's kind of static. You put it out there and it's out there, and that's great. It's wonderful. Some people do have blogs that are more, you know, with more interaction, engaging, but mine was just kind of static. It was just there. So I start watching YouTubers. Now, I had been watching YouTube before, but I used it like a lot of other people used it, where I need to know how to change a light bulb in my car, YouTube. I want to know a new way to tie my sneakers, YouTube. Or if I was just interested in something very particular and weird, I looked it up on YouTube. Now, I've been a Disney fan as long as I can remember. I've been going to Walt Disney World since I was a little kid. I grew up in Florida, so of course Disney World has been a big part of my life. Of course, eventually I start watching Disney videos. I think that back then, there weren't really Disney vlogs the way there are now, but there were like ride-through videos, so I watched a lot of ride-through videos. And I started following channels that I actually started to follow, subscribe to, and specifically watch their videos. And that was really cool. At some point, like a lot of people do, I was looking at my blog, I was looking at YouTube channels, and I was like, maybe I could do this. Maybe I could translate my blog into videos. I also have always loved people like Rick Steves, Samantha Brown, Anthony Bourdain. I loved travel shows that were funny, smart, a little irreverent, maybe just different, you know, outside of the norm. So I was like, maybe I could make my own little travel show about the things that I'm interested in. Hence, Super Enthused, the YouTube channel, was born. That brings us up to the present, where we are now. I've had the channel for over a year. We're closing in on 2,000 subscribers. At first I was making like one video a week. Eventually I started live streaming. Not that long ago I started live streaming. I only live stream very very rarely, once in a while. And recently I picked up to 2 videos a week. But I love it, I love, 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 love it. The fact of the matter is, in the present moment, this is an incredibly rewarding, creative project. I'm gonna call it a project. This is an endeavor. This is a wonderful endeavor. I get to be creative, try new things all the time, share things that I've loved for a long time, and also try new things and learn about new things myself and make friends with so many wonderful people who I probably wouldn't have otherwise had a chance to meet, because how would we have met each other? You know, it's just, how would we have? So here we are. Everything is going great. I'm really excited. Last year, I made a Happy New Year video at the beginning of 2018. I made a theme for the year, and my theme of the year was Year of Creativity. And I was like, I'm gonna be creative this year. I'm gonna make my videos. I'm gonna write. I'm gonna do all this stuff. And I've done it. I really have. I've kept my journal up. I've written down so many ideas. I've actually created and made so many videos. I feel like I've had a very creative and awesome year. And I want to carry that over into next year and all the years to come. But I'm working on a new theme for 2019, and I will reveal the new theme in a kind of another New Year video right at the beginning of January. I have an overarching idea of the theme, but I want to refine it into like a word or two or a phrase or something like that. It's gonna be building on your creativity to kind of refine and grow and move past that and push myself to go further. So I'm excited about that. So that leads us into the future. I want to keep doing what I'm doing. I always want to keep growing, learning, developing, and I hope to do that personally in my life and with the channel with you guys. Some of my goals include specific travel goals, specific places I want to visit, itineraries I've already made in my head that I'm very excited about, but who knows? Surprise travel comes up all the time. Like, I went to Nova Scotia this summer and traveled with friends in an RV. That was amazing. And there are videos about that trip on my channel. And that was an incredible experience that I never would have expected. So I'm ready for cool, exciting things. So I think that's where we are right up to now and a little bit into the future. I really wanna thank and give a special thank you to my friends who have been there with me from the beginning. I feel like we've all come so far this past year. Not just me, but all of us. So a special, special thank you to my good friends. You know who you are. I don't even have to name you because you know. My favorite commenters, who I've taken to a new thing where if I have a super duper favorite comment, I pin it. So thank you guys. If your comment has been pinned, that means it really touched me in some way. I really appreciate it. And I think I'll keep that up. I think it's a nice way to kind of give you a little nod that I really, really extra specially appreciated it. And I want to give a special thank you and a sort of, I don't even know what to call it, but I guess you would want to call it a shout out. Our community had a big loss this past week. We lost Rosie, our fangirl. She had a Facebook group and a sort of a nickname, calling herself a fangirl. Awesome, wonderful person who we will all miss very, very much. And several of my good friends have done beautiful tribute videos to Rosie, and I just wanted to make sure to give her a shout out because that's what she would have wanted. And I hope that we can carry on her legacy of being kind and supportive to one another. Rosie supported my channel from very early on, and many of our channels, and supported our efforts, and she was just like our biggest cheerleader and supporter and just so funny and cool, and we'll miss her. We'll miss her a lot. So I just want to like give her a shout out and a thank you to her and to everyone else in the community who knew her. Let's all stick together, guys, and try to be supportive and kind to one another and to all the new people out there, because that's what she would want. So I hope this gave you a little bit of insight into me and helped you get to know me a little bit better. If you have specific questions after this conversation, please leave them in the comments below, or you can send them to me on Twitter or Instagram, and I'll try to keep track of them. If they're here, it'll be a lot easier to keep track, and I'll try to address them in a future video. Thank you all so much for sticking with me through this. I hope you all have a very, very happy holiday season. I'll definitely be checking in with you before the new year with a few more videos, so I'll see you for the next adventure. And until then, you know what to do. Stay enthused.